Hello, I'm Mercedes Cecilia, and I wrote this book for everyone in the world. It's called Kusikiy A Child from Taquile Peru. I wrote it because I always wanted to write a book, and I wrote different books, but this one was a major book for me because it was very personal and it talked about what I feel is the heart of Peru, Taquile, which is an island in top of the Lake Titicaca, and it's at 4,500 meters above sea level. So it's beautiful, surrounded by glaciers and snow peaks. And the lake is extremely blue, and the people that live there in the island of Taquile have continuously lived a very peaceful way of life. And they are a sustainable community. And only lately, around 1968, is that they decide to let people come in and visit with them. And that made the island very famous. They are wonderful people, and I wanted to share that with my grandson when he was six. He asked me, tell me more about Peru. Because like many families today, my daughter was born in another country and she was raised half the time in another South American country, Venezuela. And my grandson is Venezuelan and was raised in Venezuela until just probably 3 years ago. And he haven't heard all these stories. So he asked me, tell me more about Peru. And I said, well, it's so difficult, but I can make you a book. And then not being that, the more I began to write and paint the scenes, the more involved I got. And I said, well, let's just do it for every child. So that's how it started. And so let me read some pages and then you can read it by yourself or with your family. Taquile is a peaceful island. It is so quiet that you can hear the potatoes growing under the earth, and the voices of mother whispering Quechua songs to the babies on their backs. Quechua, the language of the people, sounds like the murmurs made by the wings of butterflies. The ancient weaver taught the people of Taquile how to live in peace, how to farm the land, raise sheep, and knit and weave in looms. When Kusikiy's mother spins wool, she sings the song that keeps the sand returning to the sky. And I drew all the illustrations, but this is one of my favorites because it's exactly how the island is. And there she is, Chami, Kusikiy's mother, with her baby in the back, and all the women dress the same way. And there's her sheep. Most people only have four or five, and they take it to pasture every day. And that's when they spin their wool at the same time. And there is the terraces to grow quinoa, potatoes, amaranth, and fava beans. That's Kusikiy and a condor in Lake Titicaca. In Quechua, Kusikiy means he who is happy. When the condors listen to Kusikiy's flute, they flap their wings, dropping their feathers on the island shore. The lake turns them into totora reeds. The men of Taquile uses the reeds to thatch houses, build sailboats, and make flutes. like the one of Kusikiy. And there's the sailboats. So they have been living exactly the same way, and only just for like thousands of years, 5,000, 7,000, some people believe. So they built the boats of Totora, and they float and they go everywhere sailing from coast to coast of the lake, from shore to shore, and just around it because they have fishing. The keepers of wisdom and the keeper of wisdom and peace, Curigualpa, learned from his father how to build boats by weaving totora reeds. Once a year, he sails across the lake to share his vision of peace at the gathering of elders. He sails singing an ancient song that keeps the rhythms of the wind. Curigualpa takes gift for his friends from Taquile, crops, red and yellow quinoa, potatoes, and fava beans. So here it is how they live. Very simple. They build their homes with the stones that they find in the lake. And they have their steps. They build the terraces so they can have more crops because it's only 2 miles by a mile of island. So that's a really beautiful small island. So they use every piece of the land is done with so much wonder and care and delicate. You have to go and visit one day. On Taquile, the wind whistles words of ancient wisdom. You can hear the wind saying, potatoes are Taquile's buried treasure. Kusikiy's father, Tonio, is the keeper of terraces and native seeds. He learned from his father how to build stone terraces along the hills to farm potatoes. Kusikiy's mother, Chami, learned from her mother how to weave. She weaves Taquile's memories in the silence of wool. Images of birds that migrate to the island, the symbol for the morning star, gardens, and flowers. All of this you can see in her weavings. So this story is about a Kusikiy that is so worried because the trees are not singing, the trees are sad, the birds are not singing either. The dry drought. So he goes and talks to his grandmother, searches for his grandfather, the elders of the town, to tell them what can he do to bring the rain back to Taquile. And little by little, he finds a way. He has a dream. And in his dream, like they always give us answers, in his dream, he makes questions. Kusikiy falls to sleep, thinking how to help the stars come to Taquile for the spring rain. Maybe I could ask the pink flamingo to bring the rain clouds on his big wings. I could make an enormous kite with reeds and fly it high to hold the wind. Or I could search for Kyra, the giant frog that lives at the bottom of the lake. Kyra knows everything about the rain. So when you are in the island, in Lake Titicaca, you can see everything from houses to boats made of reeds. So I imagine that we can have a big kite also, but it would not fly probably. Another magical thing that you see in the shores are beautiful pink flamingos. And then you see, you don't see it so often, but you know it's there. Once in a while you see her coming to the surface. It's a huge, beautiful, green frog. He is like sometimes 2 feet long. So as big as this book. So finally, he decides that he's going to go and talk to the great glacier. In Peru, the glaciers of the Andes are special beings. We treat them the way that most people will treat a great-great-grandfather or a beautiful mountain, just to be there and sit and think and meditate. So the majority of Peruvians know that the mountains, especially the glaciers, are hold the spirit of life for the earth. Because it's the mountain glacier, the one that when the snow melts, forms valleys, forms rivers. So since you are a kid, you know that the glaciers are very important. So Kusikiy decides to go to talk to the great, 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 wonderful glacier that gives life to the valleys with its water when it melts, and that forms valleys and mountains and rivers. So the rest, I leave it to you, because I don't want to show you more. You can have great things to read and to question. And you will read about the stars. See, that's Kusikiy's father playing the flute. So the Llama constellation comes with all these stars and brings the rain of spring. And you will love to see it. And one day, I wish you, you can go to Peru. So I think that we should all read books about what is important for us. For me, since I was a kid, probably 11 years old, we came with our family to live in America because there was no harmony in the way of living during that time. And then we went back. And then we went to live in Argentina. And then we went back to Peru. And then we came back to America. And then from America, I went to live in Venezuela. And it was wonderful because my daughter was born there and my two grandchildren were born there. But then I travel all along to many countries to live, especially in South American small communities in the Andes. And I love the special way of life that there is in the small communities. And I think that that to me was and is, continue being, a beautiful way to connect with people. And it makes this world very, very important when we see that people continue living all over the world in small communities, making them sustainable and making families and friends, family, making a world of its own that continues giving the ancient teachings to everyone. And I wanted to share that because I consider that those oral traditions, like all of you have them in your home, they get lost and they are very important and they are beautiful. When I was young, I loved them. All I did was sitting next to the elders and listen to them, being that among my family or friends. And I just loved their stories, their wisdom. So I thank you so much, and maybe all of you can write a book. If I could, you can. Thank you so much.